G'day everyone, welcome back. Steve's Place Down Under. Today's Sunday and we're at the Sydney Antique Machinery Show. And it's a range of engines, trucks, some boats on display, just on trailers. There's earth movers, tractors, all sorts of stuff. So I wasn't going to come this year because of the wedding preparations and that, but I had to bring Dad over to pick one of our trucks up, and then we're going to get my suit fitted after this. So I thought, while I'm over here, I'll come a bit early and do a walk around and everyone can see it. It's one of our biggest shows in, well, it's definitely the biggest in Sydney. It may even be Australia, I don't know. So I won't do a lot of other talking. I'll just walk around, and I don't want to take credit for any other people's machines or give you wrong information about them. So I'll just walk around and hope you enjoy. I'm trying to get everything in. There's just that much here to look at. It's unbelievable. Even a swap meet going on here. There.
body parts to stand clear or be wary of meltdown of this beautiful old radio engine.
This is called a forwards and half track. This was that mate of mine bought it that had that big engine there. He bought it off the bloke I got the Renault and the 46 Ford off. This tractor back in, I think 2004, I drove in a world record, Guinness World Record, plough and be counted, it was called. How many tractors could we get ploughing in the field at the same time? And I drove this one just with some scarifiers behind it. I think we broke the record, then we're beat by possibly South Africa or something like that. But it was a great weekend, and the looks it got was just amazing. But it's good to see it's still around. This is one for you, Jeffrey. These are the ones you like over there. Two-cylinder, horizontally opposed. Australian-made Chamberlain, not Chamberlain being like the ones I've got at home, but Type 45. I'd love to have one of those. He bought this in a wreck, just as parts, and he put it all together. I'm sure this is the one. Spoke to him on the phone through the week and said he ended up getting it going. But I'd say that's his. Malay there. Cormac Deering. They look so good when they're not painted. Magnificent. Imperial. Is it? Yep. Here in Australia that actually drive these around Australia, these Chamberlains, because they've got a really good road speed. They've got a high road gear in them, and you can fit two people on them with the huddle seat, bench seat, however you want to say that. So as you can see, it's got a plate on it, registered. A set of discs there. So I'll show you this one. Jeffrey, if you're watching, this is one of those Chamberlain motors, actually on engines, I should say, on a pallet here. And hanging out the side of it there. Just want to pause that and read it if you're interested. I've got glasses on here and it's hard to see the screen, so if I'm not pointing it in the right direction, I do apologise. Fairly decent cylinder head on it. Imagine Australian made with the tractor. I'd say they made them in the factory. Then they started using Perkins and Detroit diesel. There's another one here. And hand clutches, these old Chamberlains. Hand clutch there. Mainly drawbar tractors they were for pulling stuff like this. Small than the other one. Made in Australia. Hello. There's an old radial engine here. I might just jump out of line for a bit and film this, and then we'll get back into it. Start up this old girl here, 9-cylinder supercharged radial. 360 horsepower, 10.16 litre, built in the 1970s. Used in planes and helicopters. It's like a Russian name to me, I can't. Any of you can see that, looks like she's gonna make a wonderful noise. Supercharged, it does say. Magnificent. I'd love one of these, but something like this here to buy would be just big dollars. she goes. Stand here with the exhaust, so you want to smell these things too when they crank up. I don't like standing directly on those propellers either, you don't know what's going to happen. I think this same bloke had a DC3 Pratt & Whitney radial engine here, out of a DC3, sorry, last year. I think I videoed it. I'm not sure if it was running though. Here we go. I love this.
Yeah, look at this beautiful old steam engine going around.
Enjoy it,
as they say. They give names to all the different steam engines. That's history, folks, right before your eyes.
We go. Hold that dog.
Tickets, and their own gazebo near the registration center.
Tractor ball going on here. Like it's got a, looks to me like a Cleveland Ford in it, but it's a supercharged, bit of a made up thing, but it should be good to watch. It looked like a 351, but it could be a big block, I'm not sure. Might go up the side of the fence here and a bit of a watch of it. And get our beer a bit where she's pushing, pulling a bit harder, sorry. There we go here. Get the full run of it, probably only from back here, but Super 70 three-cylinder Detroit. So it's been restored to a near new condition, probably better than new. Fairly common sight out here. You can see there's two more waiting to come here. I haven't got one of those, a bit of a collector's item, but at the same time fairly common. You can see down that row there, there's another three without too far. Good to see blokes keeping them, but I can't bring myself apart with that much money to get one, even though I'd love to. Maybe one day. I might get one of them running on the way back. There's still plenty of them to go. Here's one for you, Lincoln, if you're watching, mate. Little Cub Cadet. I know you like those. I don't know anything about it. I don't know who owns it. Stopping that, not with that sleep. Smell beautiful.
Celtic, Lizzie, Centennial, Port Lumon.
Catch it around the other side. Something like that with the look of the transmission in it. Oh, it's got an inner badge. Yeah. It'd be a big block. It just looks like a 351 Clevo to me, but what appears to be like a 453 supercharger, obviously a 471. Big holly on top of it. Pretty good job. Strong enough, like it's got an auto hooked up to the original transmission. Steam engineer, you got to watch around these shows. They sneak up on you. They don't make any noise at all, apart from running over bits of gravel and stuff on the road. That's the only way you know they're coming, unless they scare you with that big whistle. Ounce of noise coming out of this thing. Plenty of heat coming out of it. CD7 heater. I don't like the cab on it, but it's a beautiful restoration job. Probably how it came out. Magnificent. Nice. made here in Australia. This is what this is an engineering company that made tractors here in Australia, and to this day they still make the big, world's biggest two-wheel drive tractor, most powerful. This one here's got a V8 Scania in it, but I did believe that MT 855 was an 855 cubic inch Cummins, but I could be wrong. But that's these. This mob actually used those UD two strokes from factory. So there used to be one here with a five cylinder in it. It used to go in the tractor pull, and I haven't seen it for years. But that's quite a good example of what I was talking about. Beautifully restored, and that would sound magnificent.
I set up on it now.
Look at that draw, though. It just shows you the power that thing had put out. Look how heavy it is. Australian made. Looks like an old airport tug there for the tarmac. Super 70 Chamberlain Detroit diesel. You can see here on the other side of the lineup, there's just endless amounts of them. One there with that big stack just looks absolutely ridiculous, but each to their own. It's just good to see so many of them still around and blokes preserved them. This little grader here, I'd love to have it. You reckon you'd handle her dad on the road?
Yeah.
Do the job, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Got the boat tank on her. I would say Alice Chalmers.
Cut Bryant.
Could be wrong.
Cut Bryant.
Cut Bryant badge on it. It'd be an Alice Chalmers tractor, wouldn't it? It's a massive concern here in Australia, big, really big company. They do cranes, they do all sorts of lifting equipment, hire equipment, just obviously go back far as far as that. Whether they put that on that tractor or not, I take it that's what that means. 9G Chamberlain here, very good example of one. That'd be a 270 Perkins probably. My children in the way here. Beautifully restored Super 70, got rego and everything on it. As I said, there's Chamberlain clubs that go for drives, and these are that good road gear they got. 135 Massey Ferguson, young lady on that doing a bit. It's a beautifully restored this Chamberlain. Grader here, Armstrong, on an international tractor. She's hydraulic too, that'd be good to use that. 700 Massey Ferguson here, that'd be probably a 6354 in that. Could be a 306, but I don't think so, the size of it. 354, I'd imagine.
Have a drag with it.
Oh, you're gonna give her a go now, would you?
That's
oh, that's the end of it, yeah. That's not him on her, is it? What?
6 to
yeah. A little 40. There, is it? Go around and show it to you. Go around and have a look at them in. I'll just show you a bit of this military stuff on the other side of the road here. And for those of you interested in military equipment, I'm not big on it, but certainly appreciate it. Although I do like the old blitzers, I'd like one of these Jeeps to drive around home too. It's fairly unique, this thing. Well, United States Army. Track there too. Volkswagen were a little bit tanky. Any of you know anything about this military stuff? It's pretty big over here, but I don't know much at all. Although that's pretty good example of a tank that's restored lovely. Brilliant. So he goes right around there too, the army stuff. There's a Kenworth Classic on at the same time, but I'm not into new trucks. There's only a handful of old ones over there. I'm not going to walk over there. Bit of fire equipment there, but try and get down that way too. Actually, it's only just there. I might just view from here. You can see, get the idea of it. There's still a lot I've got to cover. Four-wheel drive Bedford there. Another little Bedford next to it, Leyland, Dennis, all sorts of old fire trucks there. Military Mac there. There's a S2 Kenworth, I believe that's a 903, that one. She went round the old white and hauling the Hume fairly easily. Caterpillar grader here, tag along. Fairly well preserved. Antique Caterpillar Machinery's owner club. Magnificent. Old D9 here. Thought it was a D8 from a distance, but certainly not when you get close to it. Machines I work on, but obviously a lot later model. Like the Land Rover clubs in town. Big Army Mackie. Pretty heavy duty. Well, forward control 40, look, she's hooked up to the back of it. Sure I've ever seen one of these in Australia. The big block forward in them, a look of her. Certainly seen them on the American Blokes channels, but that's magical, that. All right. These military blokes go above and beyond to get this stuff looking good. It's just great.
Okay, make your way to the tractor compound, because here's all the kids. They're going to have a parade in the compound of steelworks and crawlers, and just get over there at 11 o'clock and watch these kids in action. A lot of them drive better than their fathers. Hey, kids.
Hey.
Even have toys here, remote control club, I think.
Now you gotta put the smooth operator on, stand over.
You actually run that pretty well, right?
Very cool. Cruise liner Mac. Denning bus. Kenworth. T600 blew it. Okay, we made a mine. This is a bloke I bought my little Fibromax roller off in the Clark loader. Off this bloke, he's done her up. Got quite a few parts of mine too. Nicely restored C1800, 6354 in it. Fine example of a an Australian made truck. And I'll float on it too. Expect to see spiders and snakes and empty beer cans in there, but I've got to keep thinking it's not mine. That's how the old 8-wheel it'll look, just like that. And 9000 white.
892.
892, is it? Jeez. White 4000, same model as mine. A lot neater than mine, but. We'll go back down that alley in a minute. Ford's here. Love one of these, a day cab one.
Big we can get up to them.
Oh yeah. They are. Road commander. Yes, I are, another road commander. SAR is an Australian thing. It means, well, I believe it means short W model Australian right-hand drive. But you Kenworth blokes, correct me if I'm wrong. Really nice splitty here. Good patina on it, she's been preserved. The models, t-shirts. Truck accessories, I think. Those of you blokes that are into putting together kits, I used to be, but. Before I got the real thing. Magnificent. standard. FX holding. B model Mac. One of the best examples you'll see. Beautifully restored. Himself. It's got a V12 Merlin in it, out of a Spitfire, I believe. Side and starts it. You wouldn't do it in here, you wouldn't stand in here with it. That's the Dodge I did up here. Dad.
Aye.
It's the one I did here.
Is that it?
John, yeah, I put the motor and diff and transmission and everything in it. She obviously made it.
And?
You had all that made, all that back.
You did?
Made.
Yeah,
it is, yeah. Early Hilux here, she's in good order. Yeah.
You alright?
These little trucks are coming a big thing over here too.
It's like a whole truck in it. It's like a whole truck like
this. Yeah.
I can see the drag race.
One we took to Alice Springs, this one. There's Dutchie's bowl though, and get some flaps off him. There's another miniature truck here, you can see it's getting a big thing. Not my cup of tea, but certainly not against it either. Whatever you're into, I think it's just magnificent. Oh, Mac, MIR 700.
Which one is it?
Custom Louisville there. Done a good job of it. I bought from this bloke before. He's got a really good range. He gets them made himself. I'm after some of those Ford ones for that LNT project we're doing at the moment. I have bought these white ones off him before. Got Detroit ones there. I was going to put on the flat top, but I haven't done that yet. Nice McGrath ones either. Some little ones here, we need some long ones. Pan on it. So Blake sells some mud flaps. I can't see him. I want some, but I might come back.
Is that nothing?
I'm seeing what the king is.
Bloody.
Club drove. Ah, that's nothing for me. There's Laurie over there.
What is that?
They watched it yesterday. The boys are still at the door.
A lot of those blokes are in our club, I think. Mate of mine's Iron Horse there. I'll say hello to him in a minute. He's 892 and he built it himself with his brother. A few custom mods to it. In it, he put in himself. beer. Used to be just into, it was just all about chainsaws, but it's turned into a road registered vehicle as well. Hero Deer twin turbo, small block Chevy, and that David Brown. Gonna be cranky. Far out. Big chainsaw collector he is. Boss of the club, very nice man. It's his Louisville there. Tell you at home. I'll sneak out and come down this lane here. This is the last row of trucks I haven't been down. Early Mac there. Fairly unique now, I'd imagine, over here. Atkinson here. Jeez, it's a big truck. Not a dry drive, it's only a pusher. Another Atkinson there. Fiberglass cab, handmade they say. It says C2150. If that's right, that'd be a 210 V8 Cummins, 504 cubes. Looks like it's had a 3208 put into it. They were a prime mover originally. Being so short, I'd say that's what she was. But
she's had the
3208 repower, which is a big choice back in the day to repower your worn out old trucks, medium range, medium duty trucks.
Five, now he's a good friend.
I love coming to shows. People, kids whinging, it's just magnificent. Dad, can we go? D653. Cubic inch cylinders, cubic inches, engines bolted.
Yeah.
Back to back, 2 6 cylinders. I've seen this before, but it's not painted then. They run fairly good. The harmonics of it are magnificent.
That'd be hot having an hydraulic tank next to the motor, wouldn't it?
That's where they all are. I don't know, Mitch. She's higher, that one.
Big tractor, that's 7.
Thank you. had one of these David Browns. I sold it when I wasn't interested in it when I was a kid. I got it given to me in grandfather's will, and a bloke come from the other side of Australia to buy it, and I should never have sold it looking back, but I didn't know any different then. It's all operated by air. That chassis is the actual air tank, two cylinder air cooled. Not the best looking thing by any means, but certainly rare. Lincoln, and this is the one you're talking about. Cola. I'll do one off the phone too for you, mate. I'll send it through. Sure that's the one you meant. On in it. Love these old edges. My Suzu here is even in fairly good condition, and you don't see many of them rust free like that anymore. $361. $671 in it, V16 on the back, V16 71T for a little bit, 960 horsepower. Oh, it's 92, so 1692. Two AB92s. Hell of a lot of power. Sorry, mate. An old brick. Nick, too. Early fade. Probably a gardener in it. W model. Auto car here. This is the bloke that bought the remains of my auto car when I stripped it to build my 4000. So some of my auto car parts are probably on this. I believe some of it made it to it. The reason I wrecked it, and you all know how I like collecting stuff, it was just too far gone. things here for you too, Lincoln. Not sure you're into these ones, but certainly little. All Australian made, this Howard stuff. Made here in Australia, used here in Australia. Not sure if they were exported. It's just magnificent to see it all come out, and but it is still around. This is only part of it. You go to another show, you'll see a whole new range of it. But this is the biggest. Power units here. It's like the front of a tractor, don't they? But I think that's where they use all the cowlings and everything often. And they put whatever behind them. Range of Howard stuff here. These grey Fergusons are everywhere. Still respect them, but they have no desire to own one just because they are that common, I guess. One for the right price I'd certainly get, but certainly a good range of small equipment here for market gardeners and stuff. Many of them all the same. Probably got a job on their hands packing up after she all comes to an end this afternoon. But take your hat off to these blokes for setting it all up, putting in this effort. Certainly wonderful. It's just amazing so many survived and weren't thrown in scrap metal bins. And brilliant, they keep this stuff alive. Hard working blokes and women walking behind these things back in the old days. After it, I tell you. Platypus, never even heard of one, the first for everything. You like this one, Jeffrey? Beautiful. Fairly unique, four-wheel drive, a little bit. Driver from both sides. What a beauty. Not sure you need to get one today, but a little from my perspective. Is coming to an end. I've got to go and try my suit on now, but I certainly hope you all like that. A bit of stuff around here. this oil. Going machine club. Stuff's for sale, or he's just showing off his collection, but it's bloody, a lot of it's old. Wow. An early motor vehicle there, 1896, wow. It's a replica. I'd like to have that and drive around home. Good one, Lincoln. Up to 53 series Jimmy's here. Heat exchanger, obviously marine application, I'd imagine. 653 there, 353 there. Oh, if you don't mind. This gentleman's going to kindly start this for us. I heard it roaring from up the other end there before, but here he goes. Thank you. Please like, share, comment, subscribe. I'll answer what I can. None of this stuff's mine, but if I know anything about it, I'll try and help. If not, I'll research it. So thanks to those new Patreon members. We've got two more overnight. Raven Blackstar and Scott, thanks very much for your for contributing. It's just magnificent, and we'll put your names up, and I can't thank yous enough. Plus the ones that are already there, Lord Grievous and Tibsy Tom. It's just magnificent, fellas. Thanks very much. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Don't forget to check out the merchandise store. Thanks again.